Hello.
Hey guys. Welcome.
Hi.
Hey.
What's up?
Are you guys doing good?
Everybody doing all right today? How's everybody feeling?
How are you feeling today?
Today I'm feeling pretty okay. It's been a beautiful day outside. How are you feeling?
I'm gonna turn this up. I am okay, so I'm gonna be completely honest. Like, before we started live, we went swimming and we ordered Chipotle online, and you know, I'm just really, 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 really hungry. So we waited, like, I ordered the whole filling Chipotle, and you know how you wait like an hour or two for like food. So the Postmates here, well, it says it's here on the app, and so I was in the studio and I texted the family like, hey, the food's here. And Hallie was like, there's no food here. I was like, but it just said it delivered. And I was like, what? And Hallie said, no food delivered. And so I was like, okay. So I immediately got my money back, but that like ticked me off because I'm really hungry.
Yeah, and normally like we try to fight the Postmates battle, and during this whole pandemic, we've been cooking more.
Yeah.
Like, so when we order out, it's like
rare.
Rare. And it's like when we're craving something. So Chipotle was that thing.
Yeah, but mom's the goat and she like reordered us Chipotle. So
yeah.
Yeah.
If someone else zoomed off with the
hey, maybe they needed it. I needed it, but hey. But how are you guys doing? How are you guys hanging in there? What day is this for quarantine?
I don't even know. This is the third month now, because we started quarantine
March,
like early March.
And now it is.
I think you started before me.
Yeah, because right? You traveled here. I mean, it is now May 7th.
So it's been
like almost three months. So, I mean, how we're killing time. We're making music, making all these videos for you guys. Have you been seeing the covers we've been doing and everything? Those have been fun. How else? We've been swimming.
Yeah, and it's also, we've been working, like, doing all these videos and stuff. I feel like since quarantine has happened, it's been a little bit, I don't know, busier for social stuff.
Yeah,
like,
for us.
Like, it's a lot more, like, busy work for us to do.
Yeah, because our music's coming, and I don't know, you guys heard Catch Up. If you haven't, go stream it. If you have, stream it some more. We have a lot more new music coming very soon. I know we keep saying very soon, but you guys, I'm dead serious. And yeah, we just started doing the cover mashups. You guys think we should do them like more recent?
Yeah. And also, if you guys have any like cover suggestions,
let us know,
because it's been super fun for us.
Yeah, doesn't it feel like we're back in the YouTube days?
Yeah,
kind of.
Yeah. It's been really fun for us to, like, venture back and do that again.
Yeah, like, arranging the songs and, like, putting them together for you guys and all of this stuff. So that's been really fun. And I just feel like music is the true healer of the world, especially now, right now. And I just really hope all of you all are doing okay mentally. And if you're not, we're always here. You guys could always hit us up. And we hope that we make you feel even a little bit better through music. A lot of crazy stuff has been going on right now, and you know, it's just made us even more grateful for family and knowing that we can be here with each other and happy and healthy. So we don't take any moment for granted, and especially right now, like with Ahmaud Arbery, God rest his soul, that was really tragic. You know, that really spoke to us, because we have a little brother, African-American brother, and we're from Atlanta, Georgia. And you know, if you all don't know, it took place in Georgia where he was, you know, killed. So it really struck a chord for us, and we just hope that we can make you all feel better even a little bit about it through music, if that's okay. So yeah,
because this has been definitely a trying time, and then watching your community continue to be killed just for living is definitely just awful, and it's a horrible thing. And especially, you know, it hits home because mm-hmm. that's our hometown, and our little brother could have been running down the street and that could have happened to him. So it's just been a lot of like feels this week. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we want to sing for you guys. We want to sing this song for you. And what song is this, Chloe?
It's called Strange Fruit. And, you know, we don't have our instruments with us, but just a cappella. We just hope we could use our voices as healing for any of you guys who are suffering or hurting or at home. And this is definitely for Ahmaud Arbery and all of our beautiful brothers and sisters who have suffered the injustices of, you know, this world. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Okay. Southern trees bear strange fruit, blood on the leaves, and blood at the roots, black bodies swinging in the
emotional singing that song because it just means so much to us, you know, not only back then but even currently with all of the craziness happening. So we just hope that made you guys feel even a little bit better, and we're sending our love to you guys. So yeah, so we also want to bring happiness and joy and laughter to you guys. So without further ado, we'll answer any questions, or we're going to do like those fun tea time lives with you guys, and we could talk with you and see how you all are doing and checking on you all.
Absolutely. We're just so happy that we're all here together. Mm-hmm. And no matter what your week has been like, we are just here to spread love and to just be grateful and thankful for this life that we have.
Yeah.
And of course, with, you know, all of the crazy things going on, we send our prayers up, and we're going to just, you know, try to move forward with love. And yeah, that's all we can do. So everyone, how was everybody's week? Let us know, what are some of your favorite things you did this week? If you have any questions, we can open up the floor for that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, should we do the little questiony thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see. Okay.
Oh, do you want to answer that one?
Sure.
Okay. So, speaking of our album, is our album going to be more explicit? So guys, you know, we are grown now. How old are you?
I'm 20.
And then I'll be 22 in July. And you know, the album is called what?
Ungodly Hour.
And so it's the time where it's okay to be a little naughty and share stories about how we feel in the ungodly hour. So yes. Yes, indeed. And I hope you all enjoy it. And I hope you can twerk to some melodies and some good lyrics.
Exactly. So yes, it will be a bit more explicit than The Kids Are Alright. That's what you're wondering. You know, because we grow, we evolve as young women and get older and new things need to be said. So yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, home studio essentials.
That's a great one. Yeah, you could start.
Now you can answer it.
Yeah. Okay. So if you guys don't know, we create our music at home. And when we moved to our first house in here in LA, when we moved from Atlanta, we converted the living room to our home studio. And so it was really funny whenever we wanted to record, because we'd have to like ask for our parents to like turn off the living room TV. And like, it was right in front of our little brother's bedroom. And we were like, Branson, you gotta shh. But now, you know, God willing, and we're so blessed, and when we moved to our new house, we converted the garage into our studio. Yeah. So,
and that's where we normally do our lives, but that's kind of, it's like outside in our garage, and since it's been really hot in LA recently, it gets so hot in there.
Guys, it's, we be sweating.
Yeah, so we have to turn on the AC.
Or it's a problem.
Yeah, and leave it on overnight, or, you know, we can't go in there. So that's why we're in my room right now.
And remember, like, when we were finishing up, when we would just be creating for Ungodly Hour last year, before we finished it, remember when it would be really hot in there and we were like, okay, we gotta finish this song, and we don't want the AC noise to like affect the mic recording. So we'd have to turn off all the AC and the fans, and we'd be singing while we're like sweating. And then on top of that, my computer would overheat, because it's like, oh girl, you put me through too much and it's hot in here, that's not gonna work. So there's been several times where we had to stop. I had to take my computer, put it in our freezer, literally put it in the freezer, wait like how many minutes, like 5-10 minutes, and then go back to recording. So,
and then it would do it all over again.
Like, yeah.
Stop.
So,
damn, we just want to record some more background.
Yeah, but that computer and those drives got us through the album that you guys will have soon. Yeah. So I guess we're grateful for that.
Yeah, and the heat is kind of fun.
It kind of added some excitement.
Yeah, and I, for those of you who know me, like, heat for me is like no big deal. I can sit in 100 degree sauna for how long?
Oh, very long. And she always carries around like a personal heater with her, no matter what. And it's like, girl, it's getting hot.
I sleep with a heater by my bed too. Like, it has to be
even
like at least
right 80. Now in LA it's like 91 degrees around like 2 p.m. and she still has the heater on, and I'm like, girl, what is going on?
Because then that's when they turn on the AC in the house, and then it's like cold in the house. So
yeah. Hi, Candace. Let's see. Someone said we got to put bops in the freezer. Oh, that's really, really, really funny.
We have to put what?
We had to put bops in the freezer. Get it? Like bops? Like music bops?
Oh, oh, oh. I don't get it.
Okay, Pro Tools or Logic? Logic. I remember when I was first teaching myself computer software to record ourselves on, I was using Pro Tools, and I had the M-Audio box. And this was before they had the iLock things for all like the producers out there, and you had to carry around this big box just to put in the computer, just so you could access like your plugins and just even open the Pro Tools session. And I don't know what happened. I do remember the M-Audio box like completely shut down and broke. And I really didn't know what happened. I had all these projects on there and I could not access them because my M-Audio box was broken, completely broken. I was devastated. I was like, I'm never using Pro Tools again. But so, you know, that's how we transition to Logic, and we record each other on Logic, and that's what we do. But a lot of times when we're like in like the bigger studios, they're using Pro Tools, and you know, sometimes I'm just gonna have to adapt, I guess. But yeah,
I still don't like Pro Tools.
Should we answer
some more? Sure. Ooh, a day in the life. A day in the life video. What food do you all cook? Well, What food do we cook?
So my go-to meal to make myself, because I think I can cook, but I'm lazy when it comes to it. So when I want something quick to eat, I'll make like spinach and jasmine rice and call it a day.
Spinach is getting really good. It's getting really good, guys.
She used to think I didn't put enough salt in my spinach, and she'd be like,
well, okay. Me and Chloe have a different, like, salt meter when it comes to food. We're both Southern girls, but now she's on her health kick and stuff, so she won't put, you know, as much seasoning as
no,
I would
not
like.
Seasoning. Salt.
Well, okay. What is the same? They're the same thing. So I would be like, you know, I tried spinach, was it like 2 weeks ago? And I was like, this is good.
And then I saw it was just left on the plate.
But then I told her, I said, it's good. It's just, you know, I prefer a little bit more seasoning because that's just
salt.
That's just my taste buds.
But then
she got better and took my note and she actually made a bomb spinach dinner.
No, this is what happened. I made it for myself because I go, hey, because whenever we cook meals, we're like, hey, do you want some? So we'll like cook double the serving for each other because we're both vegan. Mm-hmm. And I was like, girl, you want some? She's like, nah, I'm good. So then I'm like, okay, cool.
Yeah, I didn't really, yeah. I didn't
cool. I'm not bothered by that. Easier for me. So I get my spinach and rice. I come in a room to chill and we're going to watch some videos. And I guess it just smelled so divine. And she goes, ooh, what is that? Can I have a bite? It smells so good. I said, I thought you didn't like my spinach. And she goes, well, can I have a little bite? And then what happened?
Well, that day, it was really good. And actually, when she came in my room after she had made that dinner, I didn't even eat dinner. And I was like, I'm not really hungry for dinner. But as soon as I smelled it, I was like, you know what? That smells pretty good. I asked her for two bites. And I was like, now that, whatever you did in this batch, that is the win. Okay? So then, next time she did it, I told her she was mixing up the seasoning. And I'm saying to myself, you know what? I think my note helped. That's all I have to say, because it's so good.
If I'm cooking for Hallie, I just know I just have to add like a little more salt and then she'll love it.
She thinks that I put too much salt in my food, but I don't put too much salt in my food. We have this one seasoning called Slap Your Mama.
Slap Your Mama, y'all. It's the truth.
If you guys don't have Slap Your Mama, please get on it.
Make you want to slap your mama.
It's this really good seasoning from New Orleans, and we put it in everything, right? So when we make our little vegan hot dogs, I like to put it all on there while it's in the pan and everything. But Chloe told me, you know, you put too much of the Slappy Mama on the hot dogs. And I'm like, what? Okay.
But listen, where we have a common ground and how we like it to taste is when it comes to our baking. Yes. We like stuff sweet. Oh, like, melt in your mouth.
So sweet.
Like, y'all, we can bake.
Yeah, except for my failed cake the other night.
Okay, so did you guys ever watch that lady on YouTube? I forgot her name. Rest in peace. I believe she passed. She used to make sweet treats for the kids, and she had like the best.
She passed away?
Yeah. I saw that like a year ago. I hope I'm not wrong. I hope it wasn't a hoax. But she
That's
made
sad.
Sweet treats for the kids, and she had the most entertaining YouTube videos. So, you know, Hallie made like this. She was attempting to make a cake.
So I was attempting to make a cake, but it failed miserably last week because I didn't have like a proper cake pan. Okay, if you don't have a proper cake pan, do not try to make a cake, because then it's not gonna cook it's not gonna bake all the way. Okay, so that was just a fail. And my mom clowned me. And Chloe said it was good. But Chloe was the only one who ate it.
It was incredible. Let me tell you something. It was like a deformed cake. But I kind of was like eating around it and like peeling pieces off. And the sweetness was just right. And it was kind of crispy on the outside. Mm-hmm. So then the next day for breakfast, Hallie put it in a cupcake
pan. Yeah, I made like little muffins out of it the next day.
Yeah, and she put it in there, and so now it like completely evolved, and it became Sweet Treats for the Kids, and it was like this big, and it was like crumbly and crispy on the outside and moist on the inside, and I was eating it all. I think I ate it all.
Well, I was, you know, I was really happy that she ate some of it. She was the only one who ate it, because it was literally like terrible.
I don't know if I was really just craving something sweet, but that did it for me.
She was the only one who ate it.
That did it for me.
That is sister loyalty.
That did it for me, y'all. Okay, so I have a question for you guys. I was talking so we have this group chat on Twitter with like some of our really really great fans, and we love you guys. Shout out to you guys. And so sometimes they'll recommend what type of topics we want to talk about, and they even sent like a cute little list. I haven't gotten to it yet, but we'll get to it. But I don't know why I thought about this. What do you guys think? This is moving to relationship stuff. Do you all want to be okay with farting in front of your man or woman? Yes or no? Would you fart in front of your man or woman?
Okay, so now you're talking about hygiene in relationships?
Yeah. Would you fart in front of your man?
Yes.
Yeah, I would.
Yes. I mean, at a certain point, you get comfortable with each other. And if I can't fart in front of my man, like...
What are you doing?
What are we doing? Like... Come on. It should be funny. Like, it should be, oh, I'm sorry.
No matter how bad it smells. Like.
Some people are saying, no, you would not fart in front of
me. I don't want that relationship.
Really?
No.
Really, Candace? No? Really, Pixie Jenner? You would not fart in front of your man? What if it's like an accident, though?
Accident?
If it's an accident, y'all should laugh about it.
And be like, oh, I farted. And that's it. No shame in my game. And if you have a problem with that, then you ain't the one. Like,
it has to get... Well, mm-mm. I agree with Kay drives your sleigh. She said I'd have to get real comfortable first.
That's true. Takes at least a few little months. I don't know.
I would have to get really comfortable with somebody, and once I'm there, then
Yeah, but it's like he can't see me at my best and not see me at my worst. Like, I will be wearing my bonnet. I will be wearing my Erykah Badu rap. I will be doing all of that. I will fart. I will burp, because you're supposed to be my best friend in the relationship. And if it's not that, on to the next. That's a problem for you? No.
Okay. Now what about...
Sorry. That's just me.
Now what about the other thing that everybody talks about? When you go over to the person's house and you sleep over, and bathroom rules.
What are the bathroom rules?
Like, say you have to go, you know... Not number one.
Oh, okay.
How do you deal with that if you're like, you know, just starting? How does that navigate? How do you navigate that? Like, you keep some perfume in your purse and do a little spray? Like, how does that work? Or do you go to a different bathroom down the hallway? Like,
listen, for me to, you know, take a number two around the person in the, you know, proximity of where he is. That takes a minute. I would rather hold it.
What?
Hold on. I would rather hold it for a minute until I cannot hold it any longer.
Wow.
I will hold it. But
see,
you know,
that's
what?
Not good for you.
But hold on. I know. But in the beginning, you know, I don't want to have the... I don't know if mine stinks after I flush the toilet. But whether it does or not, I don't want the smell coming from the bathroom. And farting is one thing. But that's a... But hold on. Yeah, hold it,
or go home.
That's what I say. Or ladies.
Okay.
When y'all get real comfortable, wait till he's like, ladies or dudes, wait till they're asleep. Go to the other bathroom and make sure you travel with like wipes or something, and then do that. Yeah.
Candace said the guy always has to have two bathrooms so that you can go to the other bathroom.
Yeah,
see, I would,
there we go.
If I have to go, I'm going to go to the other bathroom and then just be like, I'm good. I'm not going to hold it and then be uncomfortable the whole time and be trying to be pretty.
I'm
going to
wait till
pretty. Yeah. I'm doing good. How are you? Sitting there. I'm not going to be doing that. No. No, that's a movie.
No, but I'm sorry. I got to wait till he's like asleep or something. Question for you guys. That's something I was really curious about. But okay, let's see what other questions we can come up with.
Okay. In the same top. Like, Never Have I Ever. That's good.
Never Have I Ever? How do we play that on here with you guys?
But we have to look up. Oh, maybe they could ask.
But how would that work? Don't we need, like. But don't you, like.
How do you play Never Have I Ever?
Do you drink something or do you, like, put something down? I don't know.
Yeah.
I think it's delayed till we don't see what everyone's saying.
Yeah.
Well.
I mean, things get real in relationships.
Oh, and don't buy the poopery stuff because I heard online, well, I saw online that it clogs your toilets. And you don't want your stuff clogging the toilet.
Poopery clogs your toilet?
Yeah. Now, this is what you don't want. Doing, you do. And then, you know, you flush it. And then you mess up his toilet. Fingers. No, we're talking about...
Okay. I was so confused for a second. Okay.
Okay. I was like, what is this?
Okay. Ask each other questions, and if you did it, then put a finger down.
Should I look it up online? Should we do that? Hold on. Are we going to be real honest here?
Yeah, I'll be honest. Okay. I mean, yeah.
I don't know what these questions are going to be.
You guys have Never Have I Ever questions. Ask them in the chat, and then we'll tell you.
Okay, let us ask you stuff, and you can say whether you have or not. Okay, so let me put my computer down. Cool.
Except some of y'all be asking, wild, like, crazy stuff. We're not here for that.
No, we will pass that.
Will say pass.
Okay, so where are you guys going to put the questions?
Should they put them in the question?
The questionnaire? Okay. This is kind of fun. I feel like, hold on. I don't know what to expect from y'all today.
Okay.
No, I think they're putting it in the comments.
Okay, put it in the comments, everyone, and we'll try to answer.
So, do you put your finger down if you have?
I think so.
Do you put your finger, and how many fingers do you have?
You have 10.
Do you say start with 10?
I think so.
I'm confused, guys. Do we put it down?
Never have I ever gotten to a fist fight. Do we put it down if we say yes?
Help, yes. Yes? Okay, 10 fingers. Okay, you guys are kind of delayed. Okay, 10 fingers.
And then, okay, if we have done it, we put our finger down. Yes, got it. Okay.
Wait, okay, now put the questions back, because see are yeses.
Okay, so now ask your questions.
Yeah, ask them. Oh, man. The first one I'm a bit nervous
that I
for
saw
this.
Was never have I ever been in a fist fight. Why? Have I been in a fist fight? I don't think so.
No, technically not.
No, that wasn't a fist fight.
I have a funny story to tell. So, this is for all the siblings and sisters out there. This wasn't a fist fight, everybody. We're not physical.
It was
physical.
Not a fist fight.
So, what were we doing? We were recording a cover. This was back in our YouTube days. And so...
It was specifically the cover that we were doing was How to Love.
No, it wasn't How to Love.
Yes, it was.
Because we never uploaded this one because we just stopped.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, are you sure? Because I remember.
I think it was right after
How to Love.
Yeah, it was another cover that we never posted. Okay. And so we were about to start... No, we were starting and we kept messing up and then we started getting attitudes with each other. We were younger. We kind of had no filter. We were a little rude. We have grown up. We are kind now. We are kind.
I think they know this story, because
did we tell y'all this?
We told them this story before.
Oh, okay.
Because we were recording the cover and something happened. We kept messing up and I pressed... And I was about to turn it off.
I think you snapped at me or something, and I went like, no, hey, not too hard.
I won't. She pushed the back of my head like this, like, boom. Right? And it felt like she punched the back of my head.
And Hallie still has her guitar.
I have my guitar on.
Still on by the strap. And she turns so fast and has her hand and goes, boom!
And it wasn't a fist fight.
The camera was recording all of this.
And Chloe does.
Hold on. I'm not there yet. So. So, after that happened, I was like, And I think we ran upstairs to mom and dad because we were in the basement filming this.
Hallie
ran upstairs first because I was the one who kind of, you know, started it. And so, I didn't want to seem as the, you know, guilty culprit. So,
I started it.
I admit it. And, you know, before I went upstairs, I went to the camera
And I deleted the video.
And she deleted the video.
Current me?
That was my evidence against her.
I'm so mad. I'm so mad I deleted that because that would have been amazing.
That was my evidence against Chloe because then she got upstairs.
I got rid of that, y'all.
Then she got upstairs and tried to tell a whole new
story. Oh, no, I did not. Uh-huh. No, I did not. What story did I tell?
And you were like, well, I didn't,
What?
Hallie no. wants to do I have this, always... I remember. How old was
Someone
I?
Someone said I look like an instigator. I'm not an instigator. I'm very calm.
That's rude, person.
Who said that? Jay Dion Lee, I'm coming for you.
Jay Dion Lee.
I'm very calm, especially like now. I'm calm.
Anyway, let's go back to Never Have Ever, right?
Hold on. I want to clear this up, everybody. I'm very calm. And like, I'm sometimes very passive aggressive to, you know, and it's not really good, but I walk away and I'll be calm and I'll cool down on my own. Thank you. And I don't instigate. Thank you. Right?
Yes, she does not instigate.
Thank you.
You feel better?
Okay. I feel so much better.
Okay, everyone. Oh, yeah, you should tell them about your hair. Look how pretty your
hair
is.
Oh, okay. So, guys, I haven't twisted it, but I don't know if you all noticed, I had my twist. What is it called?
Double strand twist.
Yeah. I had that in for like 2 months since March.
Yeah.
And I finally took it out. So this is what you get. This is
yes. Okay, back to the Never Have I Ever game.
Okay. Yeah, come on, put it back because now it's lost.
Yeah, put questions back, everyone. I think I saw one about us liking the same guy.
Have we?
That's never happened.
So how many do we already have down right now?
We didn't even put down the fight because that wasn't a fist fight.
Technically, it was hands. So put it down.
But let's
do that. Okay.
Okay.
Gotten a speeding ticket? No. Can you do that one? Does that one count for you?
I've never gotten a speeding ticket.
Because you don't have a license.
I don't have a license okay. yet. I have my permit.
Have we been never have I ever snuck out? We put it down if we have?
Yeah, we have. Never have I ever.
This is never. When we were younger. Yeah. We were like younger.
What did we do?
And, yeah. You know, we love our parents because they're all about us staying focused and putting ourselves first. And I'm really grateful that we grew up with that discipline because nothing comes before our music. Like, that's just not the case. And I think it's because it was instilled in us. But before we really grasped the concept when we were younger, you know, how old were we? Like 15?
Yeah, and I was like 13. Was I 13? I don't know.
Well, I don't know. We both have stories where we did sneak out the house and both got caught by our parents both times. Yeah. And oh man,
that's just. But I feel like it's like
talk about your heart falling to your butt.
Everybody guys, goes through that.
So that's that. Okay, so we have.
So we're back here. Yeah, but guys, I think. Your definition of sneaking out is different than ours.
Like, yeah, we just went out to the street.
Of sneaking out was like running to like the edge of like just walking outside my house.
Yeah.
That's my definition of sneaking out. Okay.
Never have I skipped school? No, I've never skipped school.
Never skipped school.
Never skipped school.
Never have I ever had a crush on a cast member.
Okay. Never have I ever broken someone's heart.
I am not. You put your hand out? Okay, so she has.
Okay, you got five more.
I have six more. So does that mean that I'm?
Are we playing it wrong? We're putting it down that we have, like, if we've done it.
If
yeah,
we've put done it
down
we
if
we've
done it. Yeah, we put it down if we've done it.
Yeah.
I don't, y'all, we learning the game now. We're answering the questions.
We're doing it right. Never have I ever smoked weed. I have not. We choose not to do that.
And, you know, I told myself if I ever was to do that, I would do the edibles because I'm not messing up this voice. Yeah. And
just have no desire. I have no desire for alcohol or smoking or anything. I just don't.
I remember before I turned 21, because I really didn't drink alcohol till I was 21. I did it wrong again, guys. I'm sorry. We're putting it down if you did it.
Yeah, you put it down if you do it.
I did do it.
What did I say? Do what?
Oh, I didn't smoke weed. No. Okay, you're right. Here we go. I've never smoked weed. Okay, I got five more. But, like, even when I was younger, I used to say, I'm never going to drink because, you know, it dries out your vocals. And even cheese and dairy and stuff isn't good for your vocals. And I was like, I'm never going to do that. Well, I turned 21 and that was a different story. So, here we are. Okay. I didn't see that. Okay.
We need more questions, everyone.
How am I lying to Hallie? Exotic me. She knows everything about me.
Okay, someone ain't doing the math right. Okay.
Never have I ever started
drama with my boyfriend for no reason.
Put it down.
I've I don't know what to say about that. I kind of am a little bit when it comes to relationships and when I actually am in love with somebody, I get like a bit clingy, I will say, but in a good way, because it takes a lot for somebody to get past like my barrier that I have. I'm an Aries, for those of you who don't know. And, you know, we're not very open with everybody. So it takes a lot for people to finally get through to me. So when they do, I just am kind of, you know, sprung. And then if I want attention, I kind of just, I don't know. I don't know what I do.
Okay, I saw someone say, never have I ever stole. Okay, I have to put mine down and I'll tell you guys a story because I'm a good girl.
You've stolen?
Yes. I was...
I've stolen from you. Like, clothes and stuff.
Okay, I was 4 years old. This is when we were in Atlanta, Georgia. And I think... I faintly remember this, but I will never forget how in trouble I got. And so...
Oh, that's a good one.
I was
one.
That...
That's a good one.
What is that?
Never have I ever snitched on myself.
Okay. And... Hold on, I'm gonna finish this. And so I... We were at some friend's house. Mind you, I was four. And he had, like, these... magnets, animal magnets on the fridge, and I was just in love with them. And little me, I just took it off the fridge and I put it in my pocket. So that's what happened. And I got home and I got in trouble. And then one other time, I was still four and I was at the grocery store and I saw Juicy Fruit gum, and this was really not intentional, and I had it in my hand and I put it in my, you know, I just was loving the gum. I didn't realize I put it in my pocket, and Mom looks at me and goes, Chloe. And I got in trouble and I said, I really didn't mean to. I didn't really mean to steal. And that's what happened, y'all. So
I don't think I've ever stolen from anybody other than Chloe. Like, I go in her room all the time and get clothes. But that's just what sisters do, you know?
Okay, what was the one that you saw? Never have I ever snitched on my sibling?
She has as well.
When?
Plenty of times when we were younger.
Like, serious snitches or like...
If it's a snitch, it's a snitch.
No, yours was serious. Mine was like, mine was like over like, you did this in my room, like that.
But doesn't that count as a snitch?
Okay, fine.
If
so
you snitch, you snitch.
Okay, but yours was more serious.
What did I snitch on with you again? What did I? Tell me in my ear. Okay. Can I tell them that? Okay, I'm just gonna say it.
No names.
But basically, I think I was like, how old was I? 12,
I think I was like 16.
11?
No, I was 16 and you were like 14.
Mm-mm.
There was a
you were 15 and I was like 13.
There was a period, guys, 13. Where like we've always been really close, but there were times where I would tell Hallie something and she'd tell on me and I'd get in trouble.
Because I thought it was to help her. Basically,
which incident is this? Because there's been several.
Yeah.
So, which one is this?
No, let's do the
which
other
one is this?
The I can't take it. This
one. Which one is this?
Wait.
Oh. Okay, guys.
Okay, I got it.
We gotta give the backstory. We gotta give the backstory. So, okay, I'll give the backstory. So, middle school, I was in seventh grade. And so, I got in trouble. And so, I had my phone taken away. And mind you, I think if I was 11 here, Branson was like 4. Well, Branson had his own phone. And he had like...
had like a Motorola, like... Yes, it was a...
It was the same one I had.
Yes, the red Verizon
But it
Motorola.
Was a Motorola.
It was red, yes.
It was red, but not Motorola. Motorola's the one that you do the flip and slam. But we had the same phone, right?
Oh, God.
And so... And so I didn't have my phone because my parents took my phone because I was acting out, you know? That's what black parents do. So I would see my little brother... Can I put this down for now? I have 3. So I see my little brother's phone just... hanging around the house dead, and I have the same phone charge, and I'm like, he is young, he's not gonna miss this. So you know what I did? I charged it, and I was using it for about a month and a half, and mom and dad never knew I had.
Okay,
I remember, wait, I was cleaning the bathroom one time, and I put it in my sports bra under my hoodie. And so I'm cleaning the bathroom in the guest room, and mom comes in, and you hear and she goes what was that? I go, I don't know. Because I'm not supposed to have a phone.
Okay.
Well,
that's
let
the me
back
tell
story.
You
All right, keep
my
going.
View of this. I'm going to try to get through this without, like, dying laughing. Oh, hi, Judy. So, basically, Chloe, one day, I went in her room, right? And when we were in Atlanta, we kind of had, like, these big bathrooms that went into like a walk-in closet. So I was like, Chloe, where are you? And I don't see her anywhere.
No,
in the
that's
main
not
room.
How it happened.
No,
oh, that's okay. That's the first one. That's the first one. Okay.
So I go in her room, and I'm like, where is she? So I go in her bathroom. She's not there, but the closet is right at the back of the bathroom. So I'm like, you know, I'm gonna go in here. So I open the door, and she's on the. She's literally, like, on the floor, like, acting like she's doing something.
I slammed the phone behind me so fast, and you hear thud, right?
She looks at me with, like, this, like, have you ever seen, like, a drug addict, like, getting caught? And, like, if they're in the corner, like, she was, like, she looked at me with, like, these wide eyes that were, like, scared, like...
Okay,
what?
Get
She's trying to play it off. She said, yeah, I'm just going cleaning. I was like, Chloe, what are you doing? She threw it behind her. But she threw it, like, a different direction, and it was right in my view. I could see the phone, and I said, is that Branson's phone? Chloe, you know you're not supposed to use.
And you were like, if you put it back, I won't tell.
I said, you know you're not supposed to use the phone. I was like, 13, 12, I don't know. And
so then, okay.
And she's like, please don't tell. Please don't tell.
I promise.
And I said, if you put it back, I'm not going to tell on you. It's fine.
So
she's like, fine. I'll put it back.
Fast forward 2 weeks later, I did not put the phone back because nothing was going to stop me from talking to this person.
But let me tell you, I gave her a warning. 12-year-old me gave her a warning, and I said,
were
you
12 or were you like 11? I don't know. It's around that
age. It was around that age. But I said, if you put it back, I'm not going to say nothing.
Okay,
she didn't want to listen.
So I'm going to continue the story. So one day I'm minding my business and I hear, Chloe, and it's my dad. I go, yeah. And so I'm up the stairs and he's down the stairs. And he goes, have you been using a phone? And I said, huh? He said, I see. Someone has been using Branson's phone. I have the phone bill.
And Branson was like 3 years old. So he's like, da-da-da.
And mind you, I had this hidden under my pillowcase in my room. And I'm like, what? I don't know what you're talking about. My dumb ass did not realize he could see what I was doing on the phone bill. So dad's like, go get me that phone right now. And he goes, Hallie Branson, go make sure she gets it. At this point, it's the slowest walk back up the stairs. I'm like, oh my gosh. I know it's under the pillowcase, but I don't want you know, my parents would find out I was talking to some boy, and I wasn't supposed to have a phone anyways, so I'm really freaking out, and so I'm in my room. I'm tearing up the room, making a big mess. I can't find it, knowing it's under the pillowcase. So then, finally, Dad leaves, and Hallie and Branson are still in there standing over me like this.
Don't do that to Branson. He was doing
no, both thing. Y'all were like this. So
I will admit, I was like Sergeant.
And I finessed my hand under the pillowcase and I threw it under the bed, right? I threw it under the bed. So I go under the bed on the other side and I'm trying to like delete stuff. Cause I don't want my parents to see what I was saying. I'm trying to delete stuff. And I hear Hallie, "What are you doing?" And I go, please, let me just delete this stuff. And then you can have the phone. Please, just let me delete everything. And Hallie goes, "Chloe."
What? I was like, "You know you can't do that, Chloe." I told you can't do that. I'm trying to help
you.
Yeah,
she was like,
"Guys, you don't understand. I genuinely thought I was helping her, okay? I was 10, 11, 12 years old. I don't know how old I was. You cannot blame me for that. Of course, once I turned, you know, 13, 14, started going through things, then, of course, I stopped snitching and I realized
what was I doing. Let's continue
how it ended. What happened after
you
that?
You said, "Hand me the phone."
Did I?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
And I said, I'm in tears. "Hallie, please, no." Because all y'all know how black parents are. "Hallie, please, no. I'm helping you. This is for your good.
I really thought I was helping her.
And she got the, I'm slowly handing it to her like this. So she gets the phone, gets it to Dad, and y'all.
Yep.
I don't even need to say anymore. So y'all know what happened.
She got in trouble. And then I don't even remember if I felt bad because I really thought because I really thought that I was like genuinely helping her. Because you know the way she looked at me when she was in the closet.
Yes.
Like, you know, I was genuinely concerned for her well being.
Okay. Well, okay, so anyway, how many? I have four. Okay, yeah. I got three. Okay, guys.
So put back the never have I ever.
Sorry, we have stories for everything. Okay.
Yeah, let's wait. Let's see.
I miss getting my nails done.
Well, I attempted to do my nails today, but they look horrible.
This is ridiculous.
I painted them today. You guys don't get... No. See, look how trash that is. Mm-mm.
That's not bad. That's actually good. And it probably looks better, too, on live because it's not that clear.
It's just terrible up close.
Where are they?
Let's see. Never have I ever questions, everyone. Okay. That's a good one. Never have I ever hated a dress.
Do I have four or three? I have three. Okay.
Never have I ever hated a dress that I wore on the red carpet. Have I?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was feeling it. When we were in tell the story.
So basically.
Shout out to our amazing stylist, Zarina.
We love Zarina so much. But basically there was one.
This was like the AMAs.
The AMAs, yes. And we were choosing between two outfits, either like this, there was one that was kind of showing skin
and then, the shape of the body.
And then one was like all covered up.
And it was like these beautiful green colors. It was like a fashion statement.
It was beautiful, but it was literally like
covered up from the neck. And if you guys watch Handmaid's Tale, it's like that, you know. Not the handmaids, but
what are the ladies in the green? The ladies in the green.
It looked like that, right? But I was like, "Ooh, this is a statement. We got these gorgeous statement earrings." Yeah. All of that. I was ready to have the face beat. I was like, "This gonna be a statement."
But I said before we, I was like, "Guys, should we go with the other dress? Because I just feel like showing, you know, the other dresses are more fitted and like, you know, let's just do that." And they were like, "No, this is a moment. This is a moment."
Yeah, me and Zarina were like, this is a moment. So, and Hal was like, "I don't know if it's going to photograph weird.
I don't know if this is going to look weird, guys." So then, you know, it ended up being pretty, but a lot of people compared it to what?
The Clark sisters' dresses, Teletubbies, and Handmaid's Tale. And Allie's sitting there looking at the phone like,
"See, I told you.
And that's the story of that. But other than that, I feel like we really love everything else we wear.
Yes.
So if Hallie says something like, guys, is this a little weird? We're like, we listen to Hallie.
So now we're at 3, right?
Yeah. I'm at 2? No, I'm at 3 because I was feeling it. Yeah.
Yeah, you were feeling it.
Okay.
Never have I ever sang in the wrong key in a performance. I have.
Yeah. We've messed up bad, y'all, several times. That's easy.
Like, really bad. I think...
Hey, Brittany!
There's this one time...
Oh, someone said, Hallie said, you are off tempo! Guys, we did this blooper reel from our old YouTube videos, and, like, I was like... We were yelling at each other when we were filming Best Thing I've Never Had, and Hallie was laughing. Did you say you were off tempo? You know, someone said something, and you were like, you were off tempo!
Well, because Chloe was so mad at me. Chloe used to get so mad at me during these YouTube covers.
I'm a perfectionist,
y'all. I would mess up or something, or she would mess up, and I couldn't stop laughing because of the way she would, like, take it so serious. She'd be like, it is time. She'd be like, this, it's now or never, and I just could not contain my
and
laughter.
And now that we look back at the YouTube videos, we're like this, singing to the
and
camera.
So serious.
Y'all, anyways, so y'all, you can continue.
Yeah, she was just, you know, mad at me. Cause once I get on a roll of laughing, I can't.
She can't stop.
I can't stop myself, and it's not on purpose. I'm really sorry about it, but, like, you know, it just happens. So where were we? I forgot now.
I forgot. I think we're on the last few ones, right? Never Have I Ever?
Was I?
Because it was Never Have I Ever Been Off
Key. Oh, Been Off
Key. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We've
but
been off key several times.
Remember your talent show?
Oh, y'all. So. Hold on, save the questions. So I was... I was... Excuse me. I was in fifth grade, and... there was this variety talent show, and I wanted to sing Summertime, and listen, and there was, you know, I start singing right when the track comes in, and so I have to remember, like, what key it is, so I remember, and I'm, like, behind the stage, behind the curtain, and Mom's there with me, and she's giving me the key. What's the thing called? The pitch tuner? What's it called?
Tuner,
the circular pitch?
I forgot.
It's escaping my mind, and Mom had it. She was like, hoo, hoo, hoo. You know, blowing me the proper key. And I'm like, okay, I got it. Huh, huh, huh. Yeah, huh, huh, huh. I'm hearing it in my head before I go on stage. Huh, huh, huh. Yeah, yeah. I get on stage. I'm going, Summertime. And the song's in a completely different key, y'all. And at that point, I couldn't change it up. I could not change it up. I just had to go through the rest of the 4 minutes singing off key. Well, and, you know, if it was in the right key, I think it would have been. Yeah, pitch pipe. Thank you.
Yeah.
And if I was in the right key, I would have. Killed it for being
in fifth grade. She still killed it.
But I was so off.
Without being on
Summertime. Y'all.
She sang the whole song like
off key.
I was there.
Get off the stage, boo.
I was there. I was there in the front row. I had the video recording. And when she started, it was like, I was like, she sounds great. And nobody else noticed. It was just really funny. And then I think I did that on... some performance we had, and I sang the
always,
wrong key.
Yeah, we always, y'all, we're not perfect singers. We're still growing and learning. So
and then it's embarrassing, and then I start laughing at myself, and then I can't.
Or if you do a bad riff,
we were on
stage performing Drop, and I go, oh! And Hallie looks at me like, what the hell is that? And we just start laughing in the middle of the song.
She literally, we were performing in New York. That was what it
this
was.
Is New York?
And we were playing Drop, and Chloe literally...
I was feeling it, y'all.
she just literally went, oh! And I was like, we just looked at each other and busted out laughing. I think it was at Essence. At Essence Fest. Remember?
No.
I think so, because some people in the front row saw us laughing.
Oh, yeah, 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 it was Essence Fest. Oh, man. Okay.
Sorry,
I have two more.
Guys. Sorry for all of this.
Yeah, this is really fun. Okay.
You,
how many do you have?
I think I have 3. Guys, okay. How much do I have left? I don't know.
I think I had 2. Okay, well, put the questions in. The Never Have I Ever.
Let's see. Never Have I Ever. What should be the next
one?
Oh,
I can't wait for Chipotle. I think it's here.
Is the food here?
I think so. Yeah. So we're going to get...
Oh, did it pause?
It paused,
everyone? Okay, never have I had two. Okay, thank you, Drudy. Never have I ever lost my...
Oh, I have one? Oh. Two and two. Okay. Okay. Where are they?
Never have I ever had a double date.
I haven't.
I don't think I have.
Mm-mm. That doesn't count.
What doesn't count?
That one. Because we didn't put it down,
yeah.
Right? Okay.
Let's see. Never have I ever, guys. Never have I ever gone off on someone, then realized I was wrong. This happens to me a lot.
Yeah. But, someone said, never have I ever approached a girl over a man.
Hell no. No.
No. You crazy. Mm-mm. Girl, if you don't feel secure in your relationship and you got to go try to check another girl, you're not in the right relationship, because it's the guy or girl, whoever you're with, it's their job to make you feel secure. And if you're not feeling secure and you're not trusting them, get the hell out of the relationship.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, get mad at the guy. Don't get mad at the girl.
I can't stand that.
Never have I ever gotten rejected. You have?
Yeah, but it turned out in my favor.
I don't think I have.
Have I?
I don't think so.
I don't know. But listen, you might reject me once, but then you're going to come running maybe the next day.
Well, what is the definition of, like, what situation are we talking about rejection? Like,
See, that counts.
So, like, getting turned down.
Yeah.
When you try to make a move, yeah.
And I never make moves.
So I won.
You won? Oh, damn.
Woo!
Damn.
I won.
That was fun, guys.
That was really fun.
I'm hungry. Are you hungry?
Yes.
I think we're going to eat food. Yes. We should do this again. Tweet us or, like, DM us any other games you guys want us to play next time.
You
I'm sorry.
Run me once, but come run.
Oh, I said that?
Yes. Are y'all from Houston? No, but
Atlanta.
We're from Atlanta, Georgia. You don't know.
Now you know. You know. This was really fun, guys.
Yeah, we should play some more games again.
Oh, and all of you, stream catch up with us and Sway Lee. Thank you.
Yeah.
Let's play it now as our exit song.
Sway Lee.
Let's play it now as our exit song. Let's play it now. Let's get an extra stream.
Because are we going to play it?
Oh, I am going to play
extra
it.
Stream?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, one extra
That's
stream.
That's what's going to happen.
That's a good idea. If you guys have it on your phone, pull it out.
Pull that out
and
blast
stream
it.
Oh, guys, you want to see my pop socket? Look at it. It's really pretty. It's a rose quartz pop socket. I really like it.
There we go. Can y'all hear that? I don't know if y'all can.
Said I've already talked to myself. Maybe it's true what they say about you. You're in the loop if you knew what I knew. But then you get the hotel room.
Hey,
I smell the booze, not your cheap perfume.
Turn up. Oh, hey.
catch up and string it. Oh, oh, oh. Front to back,
thanks for hanging with us.
See you next time.
The lights were. Bye, guys.